Fire.
I command them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Say, God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
You are wonderful. You are glorious.
I love you so much.
You are God of Abraham.
God of Isaac.
God of Jacob.
I worship you. I adore you.
I love you so much. Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord. You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ. You are the Alpha, the Omega, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords.
Wonderful. Counselor.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
I worship you.
Say, Wonderful Holy Ghost.
I surrender to you. I open my heart. I open my spirit.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me. Your divine revelations.
Bless me tonight.
The Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, Jesus said that there I am in their midst, and also tonight Jesus Christ is here, the Holy Ghost is here, God Almighty is here, and we will have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
Amen.
Take your glory, Lord of Lords. Oh.
We praise you.
Baba. Erebo solo robo shanda laba. Arakato bo solo robo shanda laba. Ekaraba shanda lobo shanda rabaya lobo. Arabaya lobo shanda raba. Arakashya lobo shanda rabaya lobo. Father, we give you the glory. We give you the honor. We give you the praise. And all the adoration. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be adored. You are worthy to be glorified. In the name of Jesus. Also tonight we will have a privilege to go through the word of God together and the word of testimony tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
Our testimony reads as follows. Pain in the breast healed. There is a woman who called for prayer. She was suffering from a pain in her breast. She had gone through to the doctors and gone through scans, but they couldn't find anything. She also had a pain in her chest. The man of God prayed for her over the phone, and the healing power of Jesus Christ touched her. She could feel the sharp pains leaving her as the power of God was busy setting her free. She confirmed that she was no longer feeling any pain and could feel that her body was free. Glory to God in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12, and then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night, and we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight we will read the word of God from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 5 from verse 1 NIV. It reads as follows. After the Philistines had captured the Ark of God, they took it from Ebenezer to Ashdod. Then they carried the Ark in Dagon's temple and set it beside Dagon. When the people of Ashdod rose early the next day, there was Dagon, fallen on his face on the ground before the ark of the Lord. They took Dagon and put him back in his place. But the following morning when they rose, there was Dagon, fallen on his face on the ground before the ark of the Lord. His head and hands had been broken off and were lying on the threshold. Only his body remained. The Lord's hand was heavy on the people of Ashdod and its vicinity. It brought devastation on them and afflicted them with tumors. When the people of Ashdod saw what was happening, they said, "The ark of the God of Israel must not stay here with us, because his hand is heavy on us and on Dagon our God." So they called together all the rulers of the Philistines and asked them, "What shall we do with the ark of the God of Israel?" They answered, "Have the ark of the God of Israel moved to Gath." So they moved the ark of the God of Israel. Amen.
Amen. Also tonight we will have a privilege to go through the word of God together. believing the word of God to be taught with power. Power of the Holy Spirit, power to heal, power to bless, power to protect, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Then tonight, we will get the word of God from the book of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel chapter 5 from verse number 1. The Bible reads as follows. After the Philistines had captured the Ark of God, they took it to Ebenezer, from Ebenezer to Ashdod. I just want us to help us to catch up to say what was happening. On the day before, the word of God was talking about what happened when there was a war between Philistine and the nation of Israel. And the Bible says that when they've realized that the Israelites, that they are not winning, they say that they went and took the Ark of God. When they took the Ark of God, when the Ark of God came to the ground where there was a battle in the battlefield, the Bible says that there was an earthquake. People were celebrating that the Ark of God have come to the battleground. God is here. We're going to be successful. They were saying, God is here. We're going to be victorious. And the Bible said that they were surprised because instead of winning the battle, they lost the battle. And it was not as if God is not powerful. It was not as if God was not there. God is powerful and God was there. It was just that there was a time, but that particular time, there was a prophecy which was given that God was going to judge the house of Eli, and God was fulfilling what he told Eli. And now the Philistine thought maybe it is as if their God is more powerful than the God of Israel. It is one of the biggest mistakes anybody could do who is in the kingdom of darkness, to think that the idol are powerful than God. That will never happen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why the Bible is saying that after the Philistines have captured the Ark of God, they took it to from Ebenezer to Ashdod. When they took it to Ashdod, they don't take it and put it anywhere. The Bible says that they carried the Ark into Dagon's temple, Dagon's temple, and set it beside Dagon. Dagon was their god. Dagon's temple was the temple of their god. They think their God is more powerful than Jehovah. They thought they won because their idol is more powerful than Jehovah. That's why they are taking the Ark of God and putting it into the temple of Dagon. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying. But that was the biggest mistake that they've ever done. And they were about to experience the power of God. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Say fire.
Fire.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God. In the name of Jesus. The Bible said that they took the Ark of God, they put it into the temple of Dagon and put it close to Dagon, because now they think Dagon is more powerful than Jehovah. not knowing that greater is he that's within us than he that is in the world. No matter what, any time of the day, any season, greater will always be Jehovah than any idol.
Amen.
The Bible said that the following day, they were surprised. They were surprised because when they woke up, the Bible said that they found that Dagon has fallen on his face to the ground. Jehovah was beginning to show them that they have made a mistake. He is greater than their idol.
Amen.
I don't know who I'm talking tonight. I don't know what is happening in your life. That sometimes what is happening in your life, you are asking, where is God? You are asking God, if you are powerful, why is this happening? You are asking whether is the devil powerful than Jehovah? You are asking, is the power of witchcraft greater than the power of God? Is the power of Sangoma more powerful than the power of God? I'm talking to somebody tonight to say that don't worry. Hey, greater is always Jehovah, he that's within us, than he that is in the world. Sometimes the ark of God is captured so that he can deal with Dagon. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying. Sometimes the ark of God is captured so what? He can deal with Dagon and he can show the Philistine that in Israel there is a living God who is greater than Dagon. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Sometimes God allows the enemy to attack, not because the enemy is powerful, so that he can demonstrate his power, so that he can demonstrate his glory. That's what the Bible said that one day. The Bible said that one day the disciples of Jesus Christ, they were with Jesus Christ and they found this man who was blind. And they said that this one's disability is special because he was born blind. And they asked, for this one to be born blind, who sinned? Whose fault was it for this one to be born blind? And the Bible said that, no, Jesus said that this one, it is not because of sin, but it was for the glory of God to be seen.
Amen. Amen.
It was a similar thing when you hear about Lazarus. When the Bible said that, Jesus said to Lazarus, Lazarus is dead. You know, the Bible said that it did not start when Lazarus is dead. It started when Lazarus was sick. When Lazarus is sick, the Bible said that the sisters sent some people to Jesus and said that your friend, the one whom you love, is sick. Please come and pray for him to be healed. And the Bible said that Jesus did not go. When Jesus Christ did not go, after 4 days, he told his disciples, so that let us go to Bethany. Our friend now Lazarus is asleep. They said that if he's asleep, amen, why do we need to go? Because he's going to wake up. Say, you don't understand what I'm talking about. Lazarus is not asleep. Lazarus is dead. Lazarus is dead. But it was not as if God cannot heal the sick. It was not as if God cannot stop him from dying. The Bible said that as Jesus Christ arrived at the house of Lazarus, the Bible said that this one of the sisters by the name of Mary came and fell at Jesus' feet and said, Jesus, if you were here, my brother will not have died.
Amen.
If you were here,
amen,
you were going to solve this problem. If you were here, you were going to heal my brother. And the Bible said that she went. And the Bible said that one of the sisters also came and fell into the feet of Jesus Christ by the name of Martha. When Martha arrived, he said the similar thing and said that, Jesus, if you were here, my brother would not have died. And Jesus,
amen,
said that, I am the resurrection and the life. I've allowed these things to happen so that I can demonstrate the power of God. And said that,
amen,
if anyone believes in me, amen, will never die. Do you believe this? And the Bible said that Jesus Christ, after that, he even cried because he could see that they don't believe, they don't understand what he's trying to talk about, what he's trying to do. And the Bible said that he asked, where did you lay him? And the Bible said that Martha said that, okay, let me go and show you. Martha thinks that Jesus Christ is asking, where have you laid him, like anybody. He just wants to go and,
amen,
see the grave. Oh, this is where you laid my friend Lazarus. Like what a normal people will do, and take the flowers and put the flowers to say, Lazarus, R.I.P. like what people do when they hear somebody has passed on. Rest in peace. You died when we still love you and speak with. No! The Bible said that he arrived at the graveyard. As he arrived at the graveyard, the Bible said that Jesus Christ, he tell those who were there, take away the tombstone. Take away the stone.
Amen.
And Martha said that, Jesus, my brother did not die yesterday. My brother did not die yesterday. By now it has been 4 days, he's smelling. And Jesus,
amen,
said that, Martha, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. If you believe,
amen,
you will see the power of God. Because Lazarus,
amen,
did not die because God cannot heal the sick. Lazarus,
amen,
did not die because,
amen,
God could not stop him from dying. He died so that God can demonstrate his power.
Amen.
I'm here to talk to somebody tonight. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know what you have given up upon. But I'm here to talk to somebody tonight. It's not over until God says it's over. It may be as,
amen,
as if the ark is captured. But that ark is not just captured. This story reminds me of the story of Samson. The Bible says that the mighty Samson, who God have used mightily, one day he was captured. They cut off his hair. When they cut off his hair, the Bible says that when Delilah said that the Philistine are coming upon you, Samson, this time Samson could not fight the Philistine. This time they,
amen,
captured Samson. When they've captured Samson, they cut off his hair. They took off his eyes. And the Bible said that they took him to the place where he was a prisoner. They took him there, and he was now being a slave as a prisoner. But the Bible said that,
amen,
one day the hair grew up, and there was,
amen,
a festival. And they took Samson to one of their temples in their celebration,
amen,
mocking and praising their idol. Said that, you know, you have a problem by the name of Samson. Their idol have dealt with it. That's why this mighty man is here. It's one,
amen,
of their trophies.
Amen.
Not knowing, no, it,
amen,
is not over until God says it's over. The Bible,
amen,
said that when all,
amen,
of them is there,
amen,
Samson pulled the two pillars and everybody died. The Bible says that day he killed more men than when he was still alive. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Say fire, yeah. I love the word of God.
I'm
enjoying the word of God. I'm here to talk to somebody tonight. It is not over until God says it's over. It is not over until you win. The Bible says that in the book of Romans chapter 8, verse number 28. All things work together for good to them that love God, to them that Amen. Have been called according Amen. To his purpose. That means as a child of God, whether you are going through some stuff, no matter what is happening, it is not over until it turns around for your good. It is not over Amen. Until it works Amen. For your good. I don't Amen. Know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen. Amen.
Yes. Amen. In Israel today, Amen. They were crying. They were crying that the ark of God have been captured.
Amen.
Not knowing that.
Amen.
You know, you don't fight for God. God fights for himself. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Many Amen. Big battles in the Bible that have ever been won, it was not when men were fighting for God. It was when God was fighting for himself and fighting for his own. Like what we should study the Bible from the book of Exodus, and you hear what the Bible talks about. When the Bible says that, when the Bible talks about when God sent Moses to Egypt to go and speak to Pharaoh and say that, go and tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Let
Amen.
My people go.
Amen.
If you read very well and you understand very well from the sign and the wonder number one to sign and the wonder number last, there was nothing that the children of Israel did to fight for themselves. From the first sign and the wonder and first thing to the last, it was what God have done to free his own. I don't know whether I'm talking to somebody. It was not. There was nothing that they've done in Egypt to be freed. It was what God have done.
Amen.
And child of God, you know, you don't have to fight for God. God, Amen. As God, as his God, he will fight for himself.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why now, those who are the Philistine, they think they've captured the ark of God. But the Bible says that the following day, the Bible says that their God, they found him Dagon falling down. And the Bible says that they took again their God up. When they woke up the following day, the Bible says that this time, in verse number 4 of 1 Samuel chapter 5. But the following morning when they rose, there was Dagon fallen on his face on the ground before the ark of the Lord. His head Amen. And hands have been Amen. Broken off, lying on the threshold. Only his body remained. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody tonight that we serve a living God. We are not serving
Amen.
A dead
Amen.
God.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
We are not serving what? The dead God. We are serving what? A living God. As we are serving the living God, there will be a living proof that Jesus Christ is alive. And Jesus Christ is still the same yesterday, today, and forever. That's why you are hearing God doing tangible things. Let me tell you this. It was not a theory that they said, no, God of Israel is powerful. No, they could see the following, the previous day, Dagon has fallen. The second day, now the hands are broken off. The head is broken off. Supernaturally so. I don't know on which sector of your life you want to see supernatural power. I don't know on which sector of life where you want to see supernatural power. But may God's power manifest to show that we serve a living God in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As He turn everything around for our good in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May God show Himself strong in the name of Jesus Christ. As you come out victorious and successful in the name of Jesus Christ. May you come out with a testimony in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because God shows His power so that we may testify. Let me tell you this. Sometimes when things go wrong, you may feel helpless. You may feel helpless, but child of God, don't feel helpless. God is in control. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying. Because it is out of the problem where you get the testimony. The bigger the problem, the bigger the testimony. The bigger the testimony, the bigger the glory.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying. For example, what we are talking about from the story of Lazarus today, we have got the testimony to say that God is great. He even raised the dead. From the story of the ark of God being captured, we're going to say God is powerful today. He broke even the head and the hands of Dagon. Then tonight, I don't know what is your problem today, but your problem today, your testimony tomorrow, where you will see the glory of God. Where you will testify about the mightiness of God.
Amen.
And you're gonna say that wandi tata lapa wandi beka lapa. Tata lapa wandi beka la wandi susala wandi beka luna. And you go like no bele. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody tonight. I don't know what is happening in your life, but you will come back with a testimony in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You will come back with the proof that Jesus Christ is still the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen.
The Bible says that in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 5, verse number 6. The Lord's hands was heavy on the people of Ashdod and the vicinity. He brought devastation on them and afflicted them with tumors. Supernaturally so. God dealing with the whole people of Ashdod. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
I don't know where your ark has been captured. I don't know where the devil have done. Whether they have captured you, captured us to the kingdom of darkness. But wherever you are captured, there will be calamity in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Where the witches will let you go, let your things go. The demons will let you go, let your things go. Where Pharaoh will let you go and your things, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because the hand of God is heavy. Can I talk, can I tell you something tonight as we are wrapping up, preparing to go and pray? I want you to understand, child of God, when we talk about the ark in the Old Testament, it was the ark which the glory of God used to dwell, which symbolizes the glory of God in the Old Testament, in which today, as a child of God, that ark of God is you. I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
You are the carrier of the presence of God. The Bible said that Jesus said that when he point out unto the temple, I will destroy this temple and I will build my temples in what? In 3 days. The Bible said that Jesus said to Peter, unto this rock I will build my temple and the gates of hell will not prevail. That as a child of God, you are the carrier of God. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit, and God's Spirit lives in you. That's what the Bible says, that in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse number 16. Don't you know that you are God's temple and God's Spirit lives in you? You are God's temple and the Spirit of God lives in you. That it doesn't matter what the enemy have been trying to do to fight you, to capture you, to silence you. But I'm here to talk to somebody. They will never prevail.
Amen.
I don't know what I'm talking to somebody.
Amen.
I'm saying they will never do what? They
Amen.
Will never prevail. And wherever they capture you, there will be calamity, where they will realize that they are touching the wrong one.
Amen.
You
Amen.
Are the child of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus
Amen.
Christ have already Amen. Said that you are the child of God. You are the temple of God. And the Bible said that the gates of hell, the devil will never prevail against you. Then I'm saying
Amen.
To you, don't worry, don't cry. You will come out victorious.
Amen.
As a child of God, we are more than the conqueror.
Amen.
No matter
Amen.
What. Then tonight, I want us to go and prepare to pray. As you are preparing to pray, as you are praying tonight, God will be turning around everything for your good. So that you may come out victorious. You may come out successful. Begin to pray wherever you are. Manto praya talaba shatalaba. Araka tupaya dolobosia dalabaya de. Karabaya dolobo. Mayandala bazundurubushia dalabaya de. Arakaya Toroboshia Daraba Mandalaba Sondoroboshia Daraba Yakaraba Sondoroboshia Daraba Manta Kabaya Dolobo Mendeleba Sondoroboshia Daraba Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, fire, 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 Fire. I command them to the abyss.
I command
anything which is not of God
in my life,
in my body,
in my life,
in my career,
in our
finances, in every sector of my life. Catch fire now.
Catch fire
now.
I command them.
Come out.
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 Say,
I command.
I command.
Everything to turn around for my good.
Everything to turn around for my good.
Say, everything.
Everything.
Turn around.
For my
good. So let there be progress. Progress. Progress.
Progress.
In every sector of my life. So let there be miracle jobs.
Miracle
jobs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, all is well in every sector of my life. Say, all is well in the name of Jesus Christ. Say, Lord Jesus Christ, you are my Lord,
you are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Bless me today.
Bless me today.
Protect me from today.
Protect me from today.
From today.
From today.
I am born again.
Born again.
I am saved.
I am saved.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Say, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God,
the fellowship of the Holy Spirit
be with us all. Surely goodness and love shall follow me all the days of my life, and I dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Then today is day number 2 of our prayer and fasting for the month of May. We are on our 10 days prayer and fasting, and on these 10 days we are praying and we are fasting, and for 10 days we are planting a seed. This ministry is fasting the offering of 10 days. Find a ministry where you can plant a seed for these 10 days as you are praying and fasting together. At the last resort, if you don't have any ministry where you can plant a seed, you can plant on this one. And I want to say to us tonight, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day, and afternoon and night.
Amen. Bye bye.
Bye.
Bye. Amen.